Hi, I'm Jonathan from Protectimus. In this video, I'll show you how to protect Outlook web app with Protectimus two-factor authentication solution. Our integration adds two-factor authentication to Outlook web app logins and allows us to use different kind of authentication tokens. Please note that this video and instructions are for Exchange Server 2013, 2016, and 2019. Before starting the installation, you'll need to download the Protectimus OWA installer and register with the Protectimus Cloud Service. You'll find the links below in the description underneath the video. I've downloaded the installer and created an account in advance. First of all, I'll log into the Outlook account to show you that two-factor authentication isn't enabled yet. As you can see, the system asks me to enter only a standard password to log in. When two-factor authentication is enabled, to get access to the account, I'll also have to enter a one-time password from the authentication token. Now, let's move on to the installation and setup. Before installing the Protectimus OWA component on the computer, you need to configure basic settings in Protectimus Cloud Service. So start with signing into your Protectimus account. First, it's necessary to add a resource. Click Resources and Add Resource. It's enough to give a name to your resource. Other parameters are optional. It can be any name you prefer. I'll name it Test 2FA OWA. The next step is adding users. Click Users, Add User, and enter the user login. Other fields are optional. Please pay attention to the user login format. It should consist of three parts: the username in Active Directory, an @ used as a delimiter, and your domain name. So I'll copy my Active Directory username. It's OWA2FA. Then I put @ and add my corporate domain name, which is Protectimus. If you need to add a large number of users and don't want to add each user and token manually, you can import a CSV file with the list of users and activate a user self-service portal. For more information about these features, get in touch with the Protectimus support team. The email address will be in the description under the video. We'll also add the links to the instruction on using these features to the description under the video too. To continue the setup, click Save and let's move along to adding tokens. Click Tokens, then Add Token. Now you have to choose the type of token. You can add any oath token. It can be a hardware token by Protectimus or any other company, a two-factor authentication application, or you may choose to deliver one-time passwords via email, text messages, or chatbots in Telegram, Viber, or Facebook. I'll use a free two-factor authentication app, Protectimus Smart. So I choose software tokens, Protectimus Smart. I'm okay with a time-based one-time password algorithm and 6-digit OTP length. So I just enter the token name. Let it be 2FA OWA and click Show the QR code. Now I need to open my Protectimus Smart OTP app and scan the QR code that contains the secret key to create the token. And to finish the process, it's necessary to enter the one-time password from the token and click Save. Here it is. The token is successfully created. Our next task is to assign the token to the appropriate user. Return to the user's page, click Assign Token, Existing, and assign the token that was just created to this user. After that, we have to assign a token with user to the resource. Go to the resources, click Assign, Token with User, and assign the appropriate token with user to this resource. Let's move on to installing the Protectimus OWA component now, but don't close the Protectimus service yet. As I've already mentioned, you need to download the Protectimus OWA installer on the Protectimus website. You'll find the link in the video description. After you've downloaded the installer, run it as administrator. You will see a welcome screen. Click Next to continue. Read and accept the terms in the license agreement and click Next to continue. Specify the folder where the application will be installed and click Next. Now we have to fill in these fields. To do that, return to the Protectimus servers and go to your profile details. If you use the cloud service, the API URL is always like that, api.protectimus.com. If you use the on-premise Protectimus platform, you'll find the API URL in the instructions for installing this component. You can download these instructions on the same landing page with the installer. API login is the login of your account, the email you use for signing into Protectimus service. You see it in the right upper corner in Protectimus service. API key, you'll find it on the profile page. And the resource ID, you'll find it on the resources page. When all the boxes are filled, click Next. Everything is ready for the installation. Click Install. And then click Finish to finish the installation. Now let's check if two-factor authentication is enabled for OWA. I entered the login and password. And yes, the system asks me to enter a one-time password. I'll try to enter something wrong to check if the system works properly. As you can see, it identifies an invalid one-time password. Now, I'll enter the one-time password for my Protectimus Smart App. And it works. The two-factor authentication for Outlook Web App is successfully set up. Please let us know if you have any questions in the comments to the video, or write directly to support@protectimus.com.